Top Dollar, I got to ask you, you've recently made your debut on Friday Night SmackDown alongside Hit Row. You guys made a lot of noise in a pretty short amount of time as members of NXT. What's this experience been like, man? Talk me through your mindset and what it means to you to finally have reached the goal being, Friday Night SmackDown.
I ain't gonna lie to you, man. It's amazing because, like, this is an idea that I've had for years. The record label faction. I did it on the indies. We were called The Row because I look like Suge Knight, obviously. And so, like,
I look like Vanilla Ice. Does this mean you're gonna hang me off a balcony somewhere?
That's exactly.
I'm gonna mind my words.
Trust me, I got a move that I'm gonna use eventually that pays homage to Suge Knight. It's something I want to do my whole life. I've watched WWE since literally I was before I could walk, before I could talk with my dad. Even when I was in the NFL, my dream was to always be in WWE. And people thought I was crazy that I was in the NFL and I would tell them that I hadn't accomplished my dream yet. So, like, to get, the opportunity with the Most Wanted Treasures TV show, which leads into my debut in May, and then less than 5 months later, be on SmackDown. Clearly, the idea, not only was the idea good about, the record label crew, but also, like, the guys that I'm with are also, like, it's not me carrying it like it was when I was on the indies. I got other stars with me in this crew who all bring something different to the table, which gives everybody something to relate to, depending on what kind of, sports entertainment you like. You got the indie guy and the fast rapper in Swerve. You got Shante the Adonis is the pretty boy, but he also can work with anybody. And then you got me. I'm the gigantic rap, bully on the mic that'll say anything to anybody and isn't scared of nobody, which, as you know, coming from not being on TV 6 months ago, a lot of people don't have that confidence in themselves, but I do. So I think that, there's a lot of things that we can bring to the table and we still haven't even shown on SmackDown yet.
Isaiah Swerve Scott was obviously on the show this summer. You can go back and check out what Scott had to say about yourself and Hit Row. But one thing that was interesting to me, the vignettes you guys had, those were unique in themselves too. Can you walk us through that process?
I mean, the cool thing is, and I'm forever grateful to Hunter for this and Sean, is the fact that, like, they even said it. They're like, bro, we're in our 50s. Like, we can't tell you how to talk, how you should sound cool and be rappers. Like, we don't know. So even from the very beginning, like, we got to do our own thing. Like, they tell us what they wanted, and we went out and did it how we would do it. And every single time, whether we were doing it in the ring, like our intro promo, or we were doing the vignettes in the studio, like, I was trying to get them to, like, we were doing them at the PC, but I was trying to get them to come to my crib. Like, I have a very professional, cool-looking recording studio in my house. So, like, we were trying to make it even more real and authentic, Like, the cool thing is that we all have good ideas that we bounce off each other. And, like, a lot of people, like, there was a lot of people on the internet that get mad and say, oh, well, Swerve. Swerve was the leader of Hit Row in NXT, and now Hit Row sucks because Top Dollar's the leader in SmackDown. There is no leader in Hit Row. Like, just like there's no leader in The Shield, there's no leader in Hit Row. We all are leaders because we all feel like we're stars. We all feel like we were waiting for our opportunity, and it just so happened that it all came at the same time. And if Swerve is in a storyline where, like, when he was a North American title and he needs to be the focal point, then we shift. And this is Swerve in the front. And we all still got his back. And if it's me and Tahuti going after the tag titles, we shift. And it's going here. If it's me doing a solo thing, we shift. Like, there is no leader. We are all leaders. So, like, that's what makes our crew cool, too, because there's no egos involved. Like, do we gain anything from bickering over who should shine more when we could all just shine?
Like what you hear? Catch full episodes of After the Bell on Spotify. Follow us now and never miss an episode.